which just about everybody expected to flame out pretty quickly, their contract with EMI called for several singles and EPs, two albums, and a movie every year on top of their touring schedule. Someone asked John what their first tour of Sweden was like. He said, "It was a train, and a room, and a car, and a room, and a room, and a room." That line and their life on the road became part of a movie that opened up with the most famous chord in rock and roll.
1, 2, 3, 4.
It's been a hard. Thank you. appearance on the Ed Sullivan Shoe. Its use in A Hard Day's Night and on A Ticket to Ride from Hell inspired Roger McGuinn to make it a signature sound of the Byrds. The Beatles were less inspired by the hassle of making movies. When an animation company asked to make a cartoon film based on a song that Paul had written for Ringo, without any input from the Beatles themselves, they said, "What a good idea!" And Yellow Submarine premiered in 1968. One song intended for the movie but only made it as far as the soundtrack album, and it's probably the best Beatles song that the fewest people have ever heard.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Whisper words of wisdom, let it be. And when the finish out their contract with one more film. And Paul wanted to show the world how the Beatles wrote and rehearsed and recorded an album well. That exercise might have been more successful back in 1965 when the Beatles were recording hit after hit and exploring all kinds of new sounds, including the first ever intentionally recorded guitar feedback, which sounded just like this.
She's mine.
All of us were having technical difficulties.
Jerry, and you can go. Talk amongst yourselves.
Talk amongst yourselves.
What's going on?
Thank you. Jervis.
Okay, now I'm ready. 1, 2, 3, 4.
He's a real nowhere man, sitting in his nowhere land, thinking all his nowhere plans for nobody. Doesn't have a voice from you, knows not where he's going to. Isn't he?